Hello gamers and welcome to Let's Play Northgard, the Viking RTS by Shiro Games. It's been released about a month ago and it now comes with a full campaign. It also has single player skirmish with, let me quickly show you now, all the clans available. Currently this is version 1.1, so the first patch has been released after the after the game has left early access. And I did about a year ago or so maybe a let's try video, and I'm going to link it in the video description. I also wrote a short article on Gamers Global, and also you can find the German video on a channel I have together with, I operate together with two friends of mine. It's called Spieler mit Job, basically gamers with jobs, and that's German though. It's just a skirmish match. Okay, and here we're going to jump into the campaign. I've only clicked it quickly to see if it works, and so let's replay the story. Apparently I have three acts, because there's a prologue, chapters, oh I see. So let's play the prologue.
I am Rig, son of the High King Hargurorf, and this is my saga. It all began one fateful day. My father had gathered all his jarls to make an announcement of the utmost importance. We were to embark for the wondrous lands of Northgard. Riches, conquest, and glory awaited us on this mysterious new continent. But the Norns had other plans for us. Dozens of armed men suddenly poured into the hall and put an abrupt end to our ambitions and to our lives. They were mercenaries led by a man named Hagen from the clan of the Raven. In a matter of minutes, we were all slaughtered like sheep.
Oh.
All but me, barely conscious. And vastly outnumbered, I had no way to fight back, so I feigned death. I seethed as he stole the map of Northgard and ripped the regal horn from my father's throne, a family heirloom and the very symbol of our royalty. I had to avenge my father and reclaim my kinghood.
Okay, that's quite a task. Well, okay, yeah, we know that now. Okay, that's just the video for the story, and we can actually click here to start chapter 1, Exodus. We have safely escaped a remote region. We must now find a shore to sail for Northgard. Bonus objectives will be revealed once you complete the chapter for the first time. Aha. Brand. Proud and noble at heart, the bannerman of the Stag clan is a loyal man who lives and fights with honor. Nothing matters more to him than his people's well-being. He is faithful to you as his father was to yours, and is willing to help you exact your revenge and conquer Northgard. Starting bonuses. That's our, we are the clan of the Stag. 2075 food and wood and crowns. The Hall of Skulls replaces the brewery and produces additional fame. That's pretty cool. So they are geared towards a fame victory actually. In skirmish or multiplayer. Fame bonuses. Supplies requires 200. You gain, okay. And dedication. Upgraded buildings gain an additional production one. That's pretty cool. The game is pretty difficult anyway, so we're just going to play on normal. And I'm not sure what awaits us, so but it can be quite tough. So, at least in skirmish mode.
No strength left when I encountered a group of runaways of the Stag clan, led by a proud young man named Bram. Hagen's men had set his town aflame. And he had nothing left, not even his father, the clan's jarl, who had died at the hands of the fiend, just like mine. Our common enemy had sailed for Northgard, of which he now had a map. All I could think about was finding him to avenge my father and retrieve the regal horn.
Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, the RTS itself is based in regions, at least in Skirmish. You need food to unlock regions. You need to manage your survival, this can be quite tough. Glad to see you back on your feet, my lord. I'm actually surprised by how fast you recovered. I guess that Wrath is an excellent healer. Still, we have already wasted enough time. We must go after Hagen as soon as possible. Indeed, time is of the essence. We have established our camp far from the enemy, but we are marooned in an unknown province at the outskirts of your kingdom. I shall prove myself worthy of their trust. However impatient I am to get even with that scum, my priority is to ensure their survival. Yeah, it's all about survival. Glad to hear this. Your temperance honors you. Moreover, no revenge can be exerted if we starve to death first. Very true. Speaking of which, we will not lack mouths to feed, so let us endeavor to find food sources. Wood is also a vital resource, as heating fuel, as well as a construction material. And we also need to leave the continent and sail for Northgard. We will need to find a proper shore to put to the sea. Okay, that's the objective. Reach the shore to the north. You're absolutely right. I suggest you ask some villagers to build a scout camp and train themselves to become scouts so that they can explore the region. That's a very good idea. You are in safe and remote area. Your goal is to meet the basic survival needs of your clan. Food, wood and houses. I can pause. Be sure to train scouts so that they explore the region, then expand your territory by colonizing nearby areas, find a shore to sail to undiscovered lands. Okay, so here we go. Let's build a woodcutter's lodge. Maybe here. Hello? There we go. He automatically starts building, you know, the villagers within. Going to explain the game a little bit as I play along. Put about 8 hours so far into it, including early access. So basically, this is our main character. Well, the Brand. He's a good fighter. His stats are better than a normal warrior, I think. Okay, now we finished this, and now we need to assign one guy to be a woodcutter. Okay. Oh, I can actually make a construction queue, apparently, maybe. Like, construct and then work there. If I press shift, I'm not quite sure. Your scouts discover new areas. They do it automatically, but you can also assign them to certain areas if you've got several directions you can go into. Like, he could... Well, this doesn't go on here. But he could scout over here as well. Also, sometimes there are like treasures and stuff. To expand your territory, you need to colonize in a new area using food. Let's do it. Colonize 20 food. And for each region you colonize, it costs more. Our resources are happiness, food, which is infinite, wood, which is infinite, and crowns, which is also infinite. Later on, there will also be stone and iron. So this is now our area, and we can build a farm. Or fields. Some regions have special things. So for example, in this region we can build 5 buildings plus a defensive tower that doesn't count, and we have 1 out of 2 woodcutters here. Here you can see in our main building, when we do get the next villager, we do not have enough space, so we actually need to build a house. Okay, no one is building here. That is because it's a different region, and villagers, they just gather food. and they will automatically build stuff in the region they're in. But this is a different region, so that's why I need to assign one. Let me see if I can queue an order. Apparently not. No. Not to the unfinished fields, at least. Up here you can see 6 out of 11 villagers and 0 out of 0 warband. Warband is basically our army. It's very small and they fight automatically within a region. But you can do some very healthy micro. For example, withdraw injured units to your territory so that you can heal them and so on. My lord, reconnaissance of the area revealed a forsaken cottage. Maybe we should order a scout to search it. They might manage to salvage some resources. I agree. We will have to colonize the area before they can explore the ruin, though. So now we need to colonize. And, okay, you are going to be a farmer. You are going to be a farmer as well. And then we are going to colonize. I move him forward because, well, we could get attacked from here. Forest. This is good for wood production. Gives a bonus of 20%, I think. No, 10. Okay, it's just 10%. Here you can see our stack symbol. In the scavenge mode, I tend to play red. Later we can upgrade buildings and stuff. So this is going to be a very straightforward map, I guess. Possibly we can go like in circles, like either this way or that way. But it's important to get food. Later in winter, here you can see on the left side, you can see there's a calendar, all the months of the year. Oh, the new area is defended by enemies. Defend the training camp and turn one of your villagers into a warrior. So let's build a training camp. I can build 3 structures here. I can build 3 here. Let's build the training camp. In this region, close to the capital, or the hall, basically. Because villagers will appear here if I'm happy. Oh well, if there's enough happiness. And yeah, plus 2, 1 new villager every 28 days. Okay, I need to take one of the villagers. I could theoretically build a silo, which will increase the food output, but it's not yet quite necessary, I think. I want to build a hunting grounds first. And she's going to loot or visit this place. There's a wolf den spawning wolf. It's pretty cool. With E you can select your entire warband, including Brand, who doesn't count as a warband member. Now this is going to take some time, but it'll give us resources. Crowns and wood. You become a warrior. Costs money, so better don't lose them. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm going to go for another warrior. I think against 3 wolves. I mean, 2 would be okay. I've got 2. And this one is even improved. But, yeah, I'd rather have 2. Okay, let's attack. Here you can also micromanage a bit to ensure that they are all attacking the same units. Oh, it's actually only 2 wolves currently. The colonized areas will allow you to construct new buildings. Make sure to store enough food and wood to survive. I would like to colonize this. I still have enough wood, but not for much longer. think I'm going to use one more guy as a woodcutter. And then I'm also going to Hall of Skulls, cool. Our scouts have found some riches, 100 wood and 100 crowns, good. I'm going to build the Hunter's Lodge. Not here. Now I need you. Hurry there. The air is getting colder. Winter will be here soon. Indeed, my lord. We should expect food to be scarcer and our people will consume more firewood to heat their homes. Our military troops will also be weakened by the cold. It might not be the best time to fight. So this functions a little bit like a tutorial as well. Hunter's Lodge. Very good. You become a hunter, and another dude will become a hunter as well. And much needed. Now I need more houses. I'm going to build another house here. Oh shit. Getting cold in here. Go here. And then I should do something about the happiness, which will also increase my fame. Because I'm the Stack Clan. And I need a healer as well. Food production is a bit in the minus now. But doesn't matter. It's winter, so it's okay. Wood is still plus. I'm not going to get this wood because I think it might not be absolutely necessary. We're almost in the north. You can also, excuse me, you can also find things like sheep on skirmish maps, and they reduce the firewood consumption if they are stationed in an area by 20%. So he's a villager gathering food. You cannot speed up things, I think. Upgrading won't be possible because we don't have stone. You need stone to upgrade buildings. And you need iron to upgrade to improve tools. But you also need... this is a limited... you actually can build more stuff. There's like an altar you can build, or altar of the throne or something. And that requires 10 stone. So you need that for the... fame victory. So don't spend all your stone, because if there's no more stone on the map, there's no way you're going to get more stone. I think that the pathing doesn't matter at all, because it's always plus 6 in winter, and I think plus 9 or so, plus 10 it should be in summer. I'm even making a plus. I could three wolves, I could even attack them in winter, I believe. There's a swamp. I could build a healer's hut. Oh shit. Okay, we already need to know where we need to go. A suitable coast for constructing a port. Excellent. We should endeavor to colonize the areas up to this shore so that our builders can get there and start working. I wonder if we carry over anything. Healer's hut. Oh, I'm under attack. Okay, the wolves are attacking. But I can't build defensive towers. Well, I've got these troops, so it's okay. I'm still growing. Happiness is 3. But I'm actually going to build the Hall of Skulls. And I need another villager who will become a healer. And they just heal. So for example, I did play the the Boar Clan or something. And when they are not having a job, they just they give you rune power, which is another resource, or lore. It's called lore, and that helps you with research, basically. Also, I've now realized that because they don't have this double task, and if I don't have wounded people, I need to do something else with my healers. So it would have been sensible to build the healers hut here. Because then I can easily unassign the healers. In order to unassign healers or any workers, you need to send them to the town hall. And then if they are just civilians or like ordinary villagers, they gather food. Okay, there's broken house, crowns and wood. Let's attack. E for selecting this. I don't even need to. You can do control groups as well, but it's not necessary. There we go. As soon as there are no more enemies, I can colonize this part of the land. Yeah, he's idle because he's got nothing to do because he is injured, but you can only heal them in your own territory. Units don't gather experience, but later on with iron you can improve them. Okay, is this something, is it? No, not really. It's just one wolf. Let's kill it. Increase fame and happiness. We are the clan of Brand, sort of. Yeah, we can maybe work a bit on the food resources, build a silo. Just in case I want to grow more. Scout was hurt exploring. Yeah, I've actually got enough food to colonize this, so let's do it. And then I can build a port. Yeah, wounded clan members have 20% reduced production. You can click to them. Also, you've got lots of mouse over tooltips and so on, which is nice. Here you get clues on the minimap. You can also change to this kind of battle view. Yeah, maybe you go here to get healed. Can I build a harbor now? I can indeed, a longship dock. Let's build it here. I need a civilian, not you. Because the silo, food silo, improves food production by specialized workers. Oh, I see, specialized workers. So not by villagers. I somehow thought it works with villagers as well. You need to rest. And there's nothing special here. There's nothing special here. I'm looking at the bottom here. So just building space. I mean, I could go for this. I could go for this to get some items and stuff. Maybe we get attacked eventually, so let's actually colonize this. We can shift our production of wood. Sometimes there are events as well, like earthquakes or mythical creatures attack and so on. In skirmish mode. Yeah, now I would actually like to speed things up a bit, but it's not possible. But I think we've finished chapter one. Oh, at last. Anchors away, proud Vikings. We are ready to sail for Northgard. Your end is drawing near, Hagen. Victory! Okay, then we are going to continue in the next episode with chapter 2. Thanks a lot for watching. Until then, bye for now.